Hello guys, my name is Rahul. Today I am talking about the engines of the automobile. Engine of the automobile, you see that the engine and the car pick. Today we are talking about the parts of the engine, main parts of the automobile engine. Here you see that the parts of the automobile, some important parts of the automobile. First is the cylinder, piston, piston rings, connecting rod, crankshaft, flywheel, governor, camshaft, spark plug and the carburetor. Here you see that the first part, our main part, the cylinder. Cylinder is the main part of the engine in which piston reciprocates to generate the power. The area of the cylinder used for the combustion of fuel. The material used for the cylinder manufacturing is the cast iron. Here you see in the pick, that is the cylinder portion. There is the cylinder portion, is a piston and the connecting rod. The piston is reciprocated in that cylinder part. Here you see that the bore, the piston is fitted on that cylinder bore. That is a cylinder bore of our infield bike. That cylinder bore of the infield bike, piston is fit on that, exactly that cylinder bore. Next, our part is the piston. Piston is a part of the cylinder. It is fitted in the cylinder bore and connected with the connecting rod. Here you see that the piston reciprocates in the cylinder. Here is a piston and the connected with the, that is a connecting rod. Here is our crankshaft. That piston, that part of the cord is called piston. Here is our pick of the original piston that is fitted in the cylinder. Here is our next part, piston rings. Piston rings are fitted on the grooves of the piston surface and these rings are used to provide a tight seal between cylinder and piston. That is our seal. Here is our piston, there is a grooves. That grooves is used for fitting of the piston rings. That piston rings used so that the pressure made by the combustion of fuel does not leak. When there is a spark plug gives the combustion on that cylinder, that spring is used to not the leak of the pressure which are dwelt in the cylinder. Our next part is connecting rod. Connecting rod plays a very important role to transfer the force from the piston to crankshaft. One of the end of the connecting rod is connected with the crankshaft and another end is connected with the piston. Here you see the three connecting rod and the piston. Here is a connecting rod of the one end is connected with that piston and the another end is connected with the crankshaft. You see that in the previous picture, here you see that that is the piston of the one part of the connecting rod is connected with the piston and the another end of the connecting rod is connected with that crankshaft. Now you see that here is a connecting rod with the crankshaft and the another end. Now you understand that the what is the role of the connecting rod. It simply transfers the force from the piston to the crankshaft. It simply converts the reciprocating motion into the rotary motion. Here you see that the crankshaft, here is a piston. That piston is reciprocates in the cylinder and connecting rod is used to transfer the force coming from the piston to the crankshaft. Here is our flywheel. This is the original picture of the crankshaft. Crankshaft is usually convert the reciprocate motion which is received from the connecting rod into the rotary motion. There is a reciprocating motion and the connecting rod is used to transfer the force. Here is the crankshaft used for convert that reciprocating motion into the rotary motion. Our next part is the flywheel. Flywheel is a heavy wheel attached at the one of the end of the crankshaft. It absorbs the extra energy during working stroke. Here you see that that is the working stroke and that is the store in the flywheel. Whenever there is a idle stroke, when the idle stroke is done, it gives its stored energy. Means it absorbs extra energy during working stroke and delivers that energy during idle stroke. So as to maintain the constant torque during the all working strokes. Here is the original picture of the flywheel that is attached on the one of the end of the engine. Our next part is the governor. The main purpose of the governor is to regulate the supply of the fuel, means it controls the supply of the fuel according to the load on the engine and to maintain the speed of the engine constant. Means we see that the governor, basically the purpose of the governor to regulate the supply means control the supply of the fuel whenever the load is increased or decreased. Here you see that the diagram of the governor. That is the centrifugal governor, one of the type of the governor that balls extends when the load is more and the contracts when the load is less. That is a mainly function of the, it controls the supply of the fuel to the engine. Our next part is camshaft. Camshaft is used to control the intake and exhaust valve in the engine, and the camshaft is driven by the crankshaft at exactly half of its rotation. Means that here is our, see that the original camshaft, that is the original picture of the camshaft. There is a camshaft, and camshaft is used to control the intake and exhaust valve. Intake and exhaust valve is used to intake the fuel or exhaust which is developed during the combustion. Means it controls all the intakes and exhaust valve, and its rotation is, this camshaft is rotation is exactly half of that crankshaft rotation. Means it's exactly half of its rotation, and the camshaft having some small parts. Then you see that that moving part is called the cam, one of the part of the camshaft. That center part we called as camshaft. That is our folder. That is our push rod and soaker arm. Our next part is called spark plug. Spark plug is used to initiate the combustion process in the engine cylinder. There you see that that part, white part, is called the spark plug. Here is intake exhaust. There is a intake valve. There is fuel come inside. Here is a spark plug. There is a combustion process going on. That is exhaust valve that we read in behind. There is an intake exhaust. There is a fuel come. Here is a fuel comes, and the spark plug is giving the initiate. There is a combustion going on. Here is a exhaust come out. Our next part, carburetor. The purpose of the carburetor is mixing of the fuel with air. The main purpose of the carburetor is simply fuel or air mixture combination and supply to the engine. That is our last part. Thank you so much, guys. Keep liking, keep subscribing my videos. Thank you very much, guys.